And welcome everybody to another NNSCRA event. Feel the intensity in the crowd and on the racetrack.
They're saying he's going to be the one to watch today.
All these drivers all with one goal, become the champion.
Buckle up tight, folks. Here we go. Green flag is out.
Good afternoon, everybody. It's the moment we've all been waiting for. It's Mobil1 Cup Series Championship time. We're going to find out at the end of today who will be the Season 4 Mobil1 Cup Series champion. Will it be Pichu London, who has been atop the points for probably the majority of any driver this season? Will he finally be able to close the lid down and take the championship? He comes in 8 points ahead of Eric Matthews. Matthews currently a top rookie of the year standings, but he wants to win the championship as well. Diego Ospina comes in only 10 points back after coming off his first Mobil1 Cup Series win last week at Talladega. Callum Wales only 11 points back from Pichu London, fourth in points. And Evan Gattuso, he's the long shot today. He is 22 points back from the points leader Pichu London. What will he be able to do? 5 drivers come into this race separated by only 22 points. Which one of them will take the championship? Here today, Leia Walker, a championship contender at the beginning of the chase. She is now mathematically ineligible for winning the championship, but she'd love to go back to victory lane for the second time this season. She'll start off alongside of George Roke, still looking for his first win of his Mobil1 Cup Series career. Rohit Vidarbu, our winner from Bristol, he'll try to go back to victory lane here today. Alongside of him in row 2 will be Sean Henley, also trying to get back to victory lane for the second time this season in the Viagra Chevrolet. Well, folks, it's time. The command to fire the engines has been given. We are now getting these engines fired up. These drivers, they will file on past this capacity crowd here for 2 laps. We will then put them under the green flag, and we will see who it will be that will win this thing. Look at Pichu London starting all the way back in the back of the pack. If he's going to win this championship, no doubt about it, he's going to have to earn it. Here we go. Leia Walker and George Roke are going to get us underway here. Who will be the champ at the end of the day? Pace car peels off to pit road. We're getting ready for the final Mobil1 Cup Series event of Season 4. We are greeted, Zen Joltis. We're going to be keeping an eye on our 5 competitors during the course of the day, seeing what progress they're able to make. Most importantly, though, we'll keep our eye on Pichu London, who is starting way at the back of the pack. But right now, Rohit Vidarbu has been able to make a 3-wide move on Leo Walker. That is for the race lead. Rohit Vidarbu going to try and win his 2nd race of the season. Vidarbu won earlier on. I'm trying to remember where. I believe it actually was at Bristol. I think he ended up getting that one of those transfer spots by winning a race at Bristol. As he will go to the front now, help from Rhett Yates and Eric Burton. Meanwhile, on the high side, he's got George Roke still up there. And look at Sean Henley powering on the high side. Henley is coming. Wow, he had James McLeod helping him there on the high side, but unfortunately, they couldn't get enough momentum. Now they get split up, and they're going to start to fall a little bit further back in the field. Speaking of in the field, that's exactly where the points leader, Pichu London, is. right on board with the 50 as he is right in the middle of a hornet's nest. Look at that. There's no space to go. Here he is coming right alongside of the Dollar General Toyota of Eric Matthews. Matthews is, as we said, 8 points back behind Pichu London. He's now picked up a few points right there. He's at least 1 point ahead of Pichu London now. Oh, almost some contact up there between Kalani and Matthews. Look at them bouncing off each other. Man, Pichu London's in trouble at this point. Go on board with the car just ahead of him. Eric Matthews in the 11. Look at how close this is. Oh man, Matthews finally found a hold of the inside. That's going to help him gain some more ground on Pichu London. Crazy stuff going on here. Oh man, they're close back there. Don't like this. Oh, did somebody get in the wall? Yes, somebody did. Yep, caution's out. Caution is out for the first time today. Joshua Kalani's around. Griffin Miles is involved. Chris Dollerton, Sean Galligan also getting a piece of it. There was another car there. Who was that? Oh, that's Kalani again. Rhett Yates, the leader, and look at them. Five wide. Matthews is in the grass. Matthews was down in the grass. Oh, wait, he's off the pace. What's going on with Matthews? Matthews is slowing. He is off the pace. Second in points. Championship competitor is off the pace. He's in the breakdown lane. There's no smoke coming out of the back of that car, but something is amiss on Eric Matthews. Max Russell's got damage. He must have been involved in that incident. There is Kalani. Meanwhile, they're going to continue to battle here for the race lead. They haven't even hit the stripe yet. Here comes James Silver Fox. Look at the inside of Rhett Yates. Silver Fox, a two-time winner, trying to make NNSCRA history to become the only, well, so far, I guess I would say the only, but the first ever three-time winner in a single season in a Mobil1 Cup Series season. He's going to go to the lead now. Jacob Rodriguez, John Castle, they're working together here trying to catch up. But I think it will be James Silver Fox. But look at Rhett Yates battling back on the high side. Drag race. It is going to be Silver Fox by a full car length, leading us under our first caution of the day. And oh, they're really close back there. Oh my goodness. Henley, LaPlante, they were all getting awfully close. Oh man, they're still close. They're still close. No, brother. That I think was Callum Wales. Yes, it was. Callum Wales, LaJay Wilson, Henley. The pole sitter, Leo Walker's in there. So is Tesla Grayson. Look at Pichu London. He got through that. Pichu London got through that wreck. That could have spelled big time problems for the 50. But somehow he got through that. Caution is out for the first time today. Where's Eric Matthews? We saw him off the pace. Where's he gone? He's coming down pit road. Maybe that caution was an opportune moment for Eric Matthews. Maybe they can get him back out ahead of the leaders and keep him on the tail in the lead lap. Let's see what's going to happen here. He's going to stay on pit road. It's a scheduled stop, apparently. Joshua Kalani, though, his day is done. He was the first car I basically saw get out of shape. James Silver Fox leads us under the caution flag. Let's look back at a replay. We'll take a look at this from the helicopter view, and this happened just around where the points leader Pichu London was running. There you see the 50. Just to his right is the car that I think first gets out of shape, and that's Joshua Kalani. Now let's see where this contact begins coming off of the corner. Does Pichu London make contact with Kalani maybe? Let's see if there's the slightest bit of contact. Yeah, Pichu London goes up into Joshua Kalani. Max Russell, Sean Galligan, they're going to get caught up in it. So Pichu London, the points leader, was the start of that wreck. And I've just thought of something very interesting. I'm not going to bring it up until just a few minutes, but you almost wonder if karma's going to play out again. But there is Max Russell involved there. He came in dead last in chase points, and this is not going to help him at all. Chris Dollerton there in the 36. Oh, man. Russell straight up and into the outside retaining wall. You can't see him back there, but the Aspen Dental Toyota of Sean Galligan is back there. Both he and Russell, ever since the chase began, they've just been having dismal luck here in the Mobil1 Cup Series. Oh, there's Griffin Miles just emerging from the smoke, but I think he comes down and actually gets a piece of Joshua Kalani here. So if he didn't get damaged with Sean Galligan back there in that smoke, he's going to get some right there. Tough break for Griffin Miles, who came in 23rd in points. That's technically 5th out of the drivers that were not in the chase in points, but man. We got to look at that wreck further up, too. Looks like Pichu London's going to avoid a second one, a follow-up wreck, involving a few drivers who came in eligible for the championship, and one of them was Callum Wales. I had the feeling when they were coming here into turn one, getting ready to slow down to get behind the pace car, they were looking awfully close here. And you can just see here, Jay Wilson's going to kind of come down into the 69 of Sean Henley. Callum Wales comes up and they just kind of sandwich the Sean Henley machine. And Callum Wales, I'm not sure if that's exactly what he would have wanted to do. That was a rather risky move there on his part, and it did not pay off. Jay Wilson actually flips upside down. Callum Wales, I don't know how bad the damage is on that car. I think he's going to actually get another hit here pretty soon. Oh, George Roque, who started on the outside of the front row, just squeaks through. Leo Walker, not so lucky. Tesla Graves also getting a piece of it there in the 43. Tesla, I think, started dead last, so not good for her. And there you see the purple car, Pichu London, getting down beneath the yellow line on the apron to somehow avoid yet another wreck. What a great job by him. And I'm going to tell you in just a moment why I think Pichu London may end up having karma on his side to win this championship in just a moment, so be sure and stay tuned for that. Lights are out atop the pace car. We'll go back to Green Flag Racing on lap 7 of 15. Give you a look at the top 10. Silver Fox is the leader, Rhett Yates second, Jacob Rodriguez third, John Castle fourth, Hayden Klein runs fifth. Then the rest of the top 10 are Seth Cole, Courtney Wilson, Arnold Columbia, Jeffrey Finguy, and Tyler Young. Pichu London, where is he running right now? Currently, he is posted in the 22nd position. Evan Gattuso is ahead of him, so too is Diego Ospina. Eric Matthews has actually returned to the racetrack as well. I don't know if he's a lap down or not. We're going to have to find that out in just a moment, but he is still on the racetrack. He's in the 31st position, and nope, he is still on the tail end of the lead lap, so this ain't over yet. But if we're going to talk about some karma here, this may be Pichu London's championship. And why do I say that? Well, just because it seems like a trend may be going on here. If you recall, Ryan Cooper, our new Truck Series champion, ended up causing the first wreck of the day in his Division 2 Oreo Truck Series race. What happened? When the checker flag flew, he was declared Oreo Truck Series champion. Who started the first big wreck here of today's race? It was the points leader, Pichu London. Will karma play itself out twice in a row? We'll find out, but the green flag is back out here at Zen Joltis. James Silverfox going to lead him into turn number one. Now remember, Eric Matthews, he is still on the tail end of the lead lap, but in order to take the championship, he has to finish 9 positions ahead of Pichu London due to the fact that he comes in 8 points behind Pichu London in the standings. Diego Ospina is restarting, I think, 2 spots ahead of Pichu London. He has to pick up 9 more positions and on Pichu London in order for him to be the champion. And then right now we've gotten word that Callum Wales has got pretty bad damage. He probably won't be a factor for the win. But we do have drivers back behind the wall as well. Jay Wilson, Sean Henley, and Joshua Kalani have all gone back behind the wall. Well, just when we thought this thing couldn't get any more interesting, we've got a total of 5 drivers who come in battling for the championship. As far as I know, the only 2 that have not had any contact whatsoever with anybody are Diego Ospina and Evan Gattuso. Callum Wales, we know, was caught up in that follow-up wreck. Eric Matthews been on pit road with some kind of mechanical problems. And Pichu London ended up getting caught up in that first wreck as he was the start of it. Don't know if he's really got any damage to speak of. He obviously would have a little bit of a dent on the right side, I'm sure, after he made contact with Joshua Kalani, but I don't think that's going to slow him down any. Let's try and document where those drivers are running right now. Let's start first with Pichu London. There he is, still in 22nd. He's actually kind of lost touch with the tail end of the lead pack. That's not exactly a good thing. Up ahead of him, there's Evan Gattuso. Where is the 93 currently listed? He's currently in 20th place, and now he's gotten caught on the high side, so this isn't helping him to get to the front and away from the Pichu London machine. Just up ahead is Diego Ospina. He's currently in the 18th place. Ospina coming off his first Mobil1 Cup Series win last week at Talladega, trying to go 2 in a row and pick up a championship to boot. He's going to try and go into that middle groove, trying to pick up some easy spots there off of Hayden Klein and Brandon Bain. Where is Callum Wales running? He must be off the pace after he was involved in that follow-up wreck after our first caution flew. Here he is back with the pole sitter, Leia Walker, as well as Sean Galligan. He's currently listed in the 25th position. And where is Eric Matthews running in the 11? He is still off the pace, and he's still in the 31st position. Eric Matthews, I think his day may be done as far as winning the championship. Look at that thing. It looks like he's had a crawl compared to the speeds we see here with the lead pack. Look at him, and then look at how fast these guys are moving. They're up in the 200s, our James Silver Fox and the rest of the leaders. Eric Matthews isn't even breaking 180 right now. So Eric Matthews, what a tough break for him. Looks like he will not be the Season 4 Mobil1 Cup Series champion. Nobody really has challenged James Silver Fox at all ever since he took the lead away from pole sitter Leo Walker back on lap 1. He's got himself one really stellar piece, and let's not forget, James Silver Fox, one of his wins ended up coming at Talladega Super Speedway, so he knows how to get around a restricted plate track. There's Austin LaPlante right behind him, 10th in the chase points. Austin LaPlante has a win this season, but it was the chase that kind of killed him that didn't have him in mathematically to win this championship, but he'd love to go out with a bang. And meanwhile, behind him, you got Courtney Wilson there in the 33 alongside of Jay Juke. They're battling for position number 3. Hayden Klein, George Roque starting to get back into the mix here along with Jacob Rodriguez. Looks like the driver right now that is running the furthest up out of all five drivers that came in mathematically eligible for the championship is running right there. And that is Diego Ospina now inside the top 15 as he is currently in the 14th position. I don't know where Evan Gattuso went. Gattuso was up here. Where is he gone? The 93 is missing. Oh, there he is. Okay, he's on that inside line there, currently in 21st place. Right now, Callum Wales is off the pace. Eric Matthews is extremely off the pace. It's almost looking like it's going to come down between Diego Ospina or Evan Gattuso to try and dethrone Pichu London. And speaking of Pichu London, he's now caught up back to the tail end of this pack, so he can now go to work trying to pass some cars and build his lead back up here in the points. He's kind of running here at the back purposely, it seems. He's not exactly being aggressive as far as trying to get right up into the fray there. Remember, Pichu London comes in a total of 10 points ahead of Diego Ospina. So with Pichu London running 22nd right now, Diego Ospina would have to be running in the 11th position, they're telling me. Is that where he is? Where is he right now? He's 10th. At this point, Diego Ospina, by 1 point, would be your champion. If this race ended now, we've still got 5 more laps to go when they hit the stripe, though. So this thing ain't over by a long shot. Diego Ospina still with an opportunity to be able to take this thing. In order for Evan Gattuso to win this thing, he would have to be a total of 23 positions ahead of Pichu London. With Pichu London running 22nd, that is impossible. In order for Evan Gattuso right now, with Pichu London running 22nd, to be the current points leader, Evan Gattuso would have to be running ahead of the leader, which is impossible to do. Unless you are on the tail end lead lap or a lap down. Then you're basically not going to be the points leader. But you get what I'm saying. Right now, in order for Evan Gattuso to win this thing, he's got to win this race, and Pichu London's got to finish 23rd. And the likelihood of that right now, with the way it's looking, is not exactly in Evan Gattuso's favor. Meanwhile, battle for the lead. Jay Juke getting to run to the inside, but that inside line just not able to move. James Silver Fox with Brandon Bain. They're going to work the draft together again. Oh, but wait a minute. Brandon Bain just left James Silver Fox out to dry. Jay Juke now needs drafting help to get by Silver Fox on the inside. Here it comes in the form of Seth Cole. Tyler Young, John Castle, two championship contenders that are not mathematically eligible for the championship anymore. They're working together on that low side, trying to get something going. And it looks like Diego Ospina has slipped to the back of this pack. And caution's out. Caution's out for the second time today. For the second time today, the caution came out. I never even heard anything. I just saw those lights there on the back straightaway, so that's how I know the caution's out. And James Silver Fox, again, he and Brandon Bain working together on the high side. Silver Fox with the outside line going to take the lead back from Jay Juke. Juke is there. She's able to make the move, but she just can't get the drafting help to help push her past James Silver Fox's machine. Here comes Silver Fox coming through the final corner. Looks like he will again lead us under our second caution of the day. Oh, I guess that isn't the final turn. They're coming towards the final turn anyway. Wait a minute, Jay Juke again trying to recruit Seth Cole. Can she get it down to the inside line? Here she comes. James Silver Fox going to throw the block. This time he did throw the block. Jay Juke going to have to ride in behind. The only Honda Accord in this field is Jay Juke. Silver Fox, now this is the final corner. Here they come. Oh, I don't know if this race may end in a caution or not, too. Remember, when we come down to the stripe here, we're going to have 4 laps to go. Caution flag. There they are. They cross the stripe. Silver Fox, the leader. But who was in that wreck is the question. Oh, and it looks like it was Hayden Klein. the Reese's Impala involved right there. Jacob Rodriguez may have also gotten a piece of it. And Eric Matthews did not go a lap down to the leaders either. Pichu London dropped back too. I wonder if he was possibly involved in that. I don't know. Well, he's in 19th, so maybe not. Maybe he did pick up some spots. Oh, Evan Gattuso, though, slipped way back. He's 21st. So London is 19th. That would mean that Diego Espina would have to be running currently in the 8th position or better. Is that where he's running at this moment? Oh, he's in 10th place. Wow. This is going to be close. Especially if we are going to get back to green flag racing, which I'm hoping we are. We've got a total of 4 laps to go. Let's quickly look back at a replay of what happened to Hayden Klein. Let's take a good look at this, see what exactly went down. Oh, contact there, and it was between Jacob Rodriguez and Hayden Klein. Jake Rogers also gets a piece of it there in the 19. Oh, and then Jacob Rodriguez gets turned around. Look at Pichu London trying to work his way past here. Oh, wait a minute, Pichu London! Oh my goodness, how did he get through that? How did he get through that? And there's Gattuso. Oh, so that's why Gattuso was running so far back. He got the wall there with the left front. Hayden Klein spins it around there on the entrance to pit road. You see Jacob Rodriguez back there on the apron. And Jake Rogers, we're going on board here with the 50. I can't believe Pichu London was able to get his way through there. Would somebody please get me a heart monitor on Pichu London? I think he may have flatlined right here. Watch this. Wow! And he nearly went up into James McLeod. What a move right there by Pichu London. And the question is that the move that will get him the championship today? Only time will tell. Let's go back and see if we will get back to green flag racing. Well, folks, they were trying to get this track cleared up, but it looks like this race will end under caution. So NNSCRA history will be made with James Silver Fox becoming the first 3-time Mobil 1 Cup Series winner in a single season, as he will be the winner of today's race at Zen Joltis, the Huggies 300 version 3. But more important news, we gotta find out where these drivers are running right now. Pichu London is currently scored in the 19th position. We've gotta see here, he ended up coming in a total of 10 points ahead of Diego Ospina. In order for Diego Ospina to win the championship, Ospina would be having to run in the 9th position. Where is Ospina running here in this final lap? He is running in 10th place. He is 10th, which means by one single point, Pichu London is your Season 4 Mobil 1 Cup Series champion. And folks, karma has played itself out again. For the second time this race weekend, the driver who causes the first big wreck of the day walks away with the championship. Of course, I can't really say walks away because Pichu London, only 1 point he beats Diego Ospina by. That was awfully close. Here they come, down to the stripe. James Silver Fox will win at Zen Joltis, his third win of the season. Pichu London is your Season 4 Mobil 1 Cup Series champion. But you gotta give credit to Diego Ospina. Man, did he make it close. But what a job by that 50 crew. And Pichu London, you can't say he didn't earn that championship today. I mean, for heaven's sakes, he nearly got up in that first wreck. He nearly was involved in the follow-up wreck there that involved Sean Henley and Callum Wales and others. And then our second caution of the day coming out, and he just narrowly missed Jake Rogers and Joshua Kalani there, or not Joshua Kalani, I'm sorry, it was actually Hayden Klein. But my goodness, Pichu London, what a roller coaster ride today, but the end result is that he is the champion in the Mobil 1 Cup Series. And you know what's kind of interesting too, not only do we have it where the driver who caused the first wreck wins the championship, but for the second time this race weekend, our champion will not be returning next season. Pichu London will be not running in a full-time schedule in the Mobil 1 Cup Series. So, in what will be his final start until possibly Season 6 in the Mobil 1 Cup Series, Pichu London is the champ here today. Man, talk about overcoming the odds. So close for Diego Ospina, but tremendous credit to him. But big time kudos to Pichu London. He is your Season 4 Mobil1 Cup Series champion. And folks, Season 4 of the Mobil1 Cup Series is over. Already we've crowned ourselves an Oreo Truck Series champion in Ryan Cooper. Now a Mobil1 Cup Series champion in Pichu London. All eyes now turn to the big one, the Snickers Cup Series championship. Who will walk away with that? Hope you guys enjoyed today's race. Hope you guys enjoyed this season in Season 4. If you did, please give this video a like. Subscribe to become a part of the crew today. Once again, big time congratulations to Pichu London on being the Season 4 NNSCRA Mobil1 Cup Series champion. And here comes your official finisher result, as well as your final rookie and final overall point standings here today. Oh yeah, Eric Matthews, he ended up winning Rookie of the Year as well, so congratulations to him with that as well. So even though he didn't win the championship, he is Rookie of the Year, so congratulations to Eric Matthews on being Season 4 Mobil1 Cup Series Rookie of the Year as well. You've been watching a production of the NNSCRA Offline Race at Best. See you guys next season in Season 5, and we'll see you also here for the finale of the Snickers Cup Series. Thank you.